Hello. He was being your
still
comedy
his
foil.
Face.
Look at that.
Take a look up there.
Still hiding his face.
You thought it was going to be crushed to death.
You know what? He hasn't told his girlfriend where he is, and he's just been seen.
Oh.
That is what the problem is.
Oh.
He's been caught out with another woman. You were sat on his lap when the camera came to him.
Well, could be lucky someday.
We were talking to Rebecca there about soaps and things.
Yeah.
If you could have ever been in a soap, Home and Away, Grab Your Fancy?
The Golden Girls.
The Golden Girls?
I love the Golden Girls. Yeah. I really, really do. I even watch the episodes now. To me, that these five ladies, five American ladies, have so much talent and so many years of experience of comedy that they just, well, they're the tops.
So you mean you're in awe? I mean, you've done 25 years yourself. I'm 25 years.
Yes, you're right, actually. I've been in business 40 years, I had to think for a minute. No, I think they are the best. I really, really do. They've got such talent, those ladies.
So what is it then that differentiates, say, somebody who's quite good to those people you think are wonderful at comedy?
Well, it's difficult to say. You've either got it or you haven't, or you can bring it out. I mean, some of the comics I've worked with have brought it out of me, that I can do comedy, which I didn't think I could, because I started off as a serious actress. You know, I was going to be Camille, do all the great things. Look what happened.
So who brought out your greatest, though?
I suppose Benny Hill, to start with. I was with him on and off for about 5 years, and he taught me a lot about comedy. He really did. And then when I met Russ, Russ really pulled it out. And I worked so well with him, and I love working with him. He's a great guy. He really is. And we got on fine.
We've got a shot of you, actually, as a Blunder Woman.
Never seen Wonder Woman. I was from the straight side, so I didn't know what was going on. And I saw this costume. I thought, I'm not putting that on. I'd never seen Wonder Woman. And I put the costume on and did me up. I twirled round, me bosoms fell out. And it was very embarrassing because Dustin G, bless his dear little cotton socks, he just laughed at me for over an hour. And for the next week, he just kept winking at me. And I shoved them in and carried on.
True professional.
Nothing else to do.
That whole thing, the Russ Abbott show came out of the Freddie Starr Madhouse, didn't it?
Well, yes, it did, but on my pay sheet it had the Abbott Starr Madhouse. Russ by then was about to leave the Black Abbotts and go on his own, so they were, I think, grooming him to have his own show, which happened.
So is Freddie, now you've worked with Freddie Starr,
yes,
as well, is he barking mad?
He's very zany, you never know what to expect. I mean, I've worked with him and I remember that we would rehearsal day. We'd have a camera rehearsal in the afternoon when he'd have a rest. And at night, we'd do the show and he'd do something completely different, which we hadn't rehearsed. And believe you me, that's the way to learn.
Really? Yeah, well, it's like Steve every day, really.
Is it? Well, Steve.
Nothing like me any day at all.
You sure?
Positive. Well,
depends what day you get him. But you know, you're back with Russ Abbott now, aren't you?
Yes, we've just finished a radio series which goes out the 13th of November. And I had the time of my life. We've done 8 shows. They go out, I think, on a Thursday and a Saturday. You know, Thursday live and then repeated on the Saturday. And we had such fun. And I found out after 40 years in the business, I love radio. You see, when I was young, we didn't have television. We had radio, and I realised that that's what I want to do, radio.
It's very difficult to do this, different type of comedy altogether, isn't it? Because a lot of the stuff you were saying there about Blunder Woman and things, very
yes,
visual comedy.
Yes.
And now you haven't got that to play on anymore.
Well, no. You know, when I was first told that we were going to do a radio series, I thought, it'll never work. You know, it's visual. But it's worked beautifully, because the people know the characters. Therefore, when you're hearing, you can, you know what's going on.
Is it more sketches again?
Oh, yes, it's sketches and songs and things. It's just fun, half an hour of fun.
Are you writing it as well, or are you just very much acting?
Oh, I'm very much acting. I'm not a writer. I'm not a funny lady. I need a script. I am a comedy actress, not a comedian.
So this is very difficult, because I've heard Ronnie Barker say the same thing, that he's not a funny man, but he needs a script.
That's right, it's true.
But to be funny, surely you must have the kind of mind that makes people laugh.
Well, it's very strange, because I don't see myself as a funny lady. And some of my friends have said, because you don't think you're funny, you are. Yeah. You know, if you go out to be funny, you won't be funny. But if you go out with a sense of humour and you've got funny lines, you just feed your comic the best that you can to get as many lines for him as you can, and it becomes laughter and comedy.
Do you think you have to look a certain way, Bella?
I'd say no. I mean, look at me. I mean, a sack, I'd say I looked. You know, Dracula's grandmother now. I've never been good-looking, and I've never been small. I've always been very big-built, because I used to do sport when I was young. I used to be a swimmer. I used to play cricket.
I was, cricket, really?
Yes. Oh, I love
big
cricket.
Big cricket fan.
Oh, yes. Ladies, haven't I?
The ladies? Oh, I see.
Yes.
Didn't know what you were pointing out then, Bella.
No, that's the other one. no, a lady.
So, what, bowler or batter?
I did both. I used to play for Portslade Ladies when I was in my teens, and I love it. And I go and watch it now. Yes, I've been to Lord's recently, and
so, of course, being famous, you get to meet them all as well, presumably.
I have been very lucky. I met my heartthrob when I was 9 years old, Dennis Compton. And alas, he died earlier this year. But I've been a Lady Taverner for 7 years, and I met Dennis again, and I told him all about my running after him to get his autograph at Hove, and we became quite good friends. And he is the inspiration of why I love cricket like I do. I really love that game.
Oh.
And another thing, is this true that you could be found late at night in graveyards? Are you into graveyards?
I'm into graveyards, but not late at night. No, when I go on tour places like that, say you're in a theatre for a week, you like to go places of interest. Well, I go around graveyards and old churches to see the tombstones, to see how people lived, and what age they died, and try to imagine what it was like at that time in life. And I think that Sir Donald Sinden is into churches as well.
Do you do rubbings?
Oh, no, 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 nothing like that. But I'm very interested in how people lived in the old days and, you know, when they died and things like that.
I suppose it's handy with the work that you do that you get to travel around the country and see
That's
a lot of
right.
places anyway.
I mean, Whitby is the place I love most of all. I think I've been on this...
It's another place associated with Dracula.
I know it is. I know it is.
Bram Stoker... Where he landed, wasn't it? He was supposed to
land... He wrote it up there.
Yeah.
And, you know, the setting is at Whitby. But I think I've been alive before and I've been... I think I was a nun, of all things. and I've been in the Abbey. I knew the place. And also the church, which I'd never been into, next door to the ruins of the Abbey. I knew what was behind that door. You tell me how I knew that. I didn't know.
So you're saying you've been...
cold.
Reincarnated.
Because it was just how I knew it was. It was terrifying.
Really?
Mm,
have
absolutely.
You tried the regression thing that people do?
Oh, no, no.
You don't fancy it?
No, thank you. No.
But wouldn't that satisfy curiosity if you really think you've been here before?
Not really, no. No, because I believe in God, I believe in Jesus. And I think we're all given an allotted time on this earth, and possibly we do come back. Who knows? I want somebody to tell me. You know, come back, somebody, and let me know.
And
Jesus has been back.
Well, yes, well, many people believe
it. He's been back, you know what's behind that church door.
Well, I knew what was, yes, but it was terrifying. Everything was as I imagined it, and there. It was as if I'd gone back about 100 years. It was...
I wanted to get... You were talking to terrifying there, but I wanted to go back to funny because you have worked with some of my all-time heroes in comedy.
Yeah.
Who's the funniest man or woman that you've worked with?
That's very difficult to say because they're all different in their own ways. I love working with Russ. He makes me laugh a lot. Benny Hill was a genius. He really was. He really made me...
Because he went out of favour here, didn't he? He's massive around the rest of the world.
I don't understand it. I really don't, because he's still the best. He really, really is. I mean, he wrote the comedy. He wrote it all himself. And he knew what worked and what didn't work. And that's why he stayed at the top.
Do you think we went through a politically correct stage and what he was doing, chasing all the women round without much clothes, all of a sudden came out of vogue?
Next time you see Benny Hill, what's the runoff at the end? It's the girls that chase him. He never chases the girls.
Yeah, but they didn't
they
have much
him.
On, did they?
Well, no, I felt sorry for him because it was in September usually and I was, you know, playing the old battle axe and lots of clothes on. And there they were in their bikinis and their goose pimples on their goose pimples. I did feel sorry for them.
Are they all very serious about their comedy? Because that's the other thing about comedians, they tend to be very serious off screen.
Oh, absolutely.
So that none of them were really sort of the type of people that were great laughs in
I think Liz Dawson. I was very fond of Liz. I worked with him a few times and he had a lovely sense of humour. And he wasn't quite as serious as the others, but he was still serious.
Really?
So comedy is a very serious business.
Yeah. Well. I'll tell you something else, which is seems to be getting serious because it's that time of the year again. Rebecca Croft was in a panto. You're going to be in Dick Whittington.
I am. I'm playing Fairy Bow Bells at the Lyceum in Sheffield. I'm looking forward to it.
Nice little costume for that.
Oh, yes, the one I wore in Bath last year. It's the only one I can get into. But we had a panto launch this morning and we're all getting together and all going our little ways to our different little theatres and pantos and hopefully pack them all in.
You were talking about, you've said about comedy and you started out a serious actress.
Yes.
Is there any, have you wanted to go on and do a serious film or a dramatic film, any type of film you'd like to have done?
Oh, yes. I mean, I wanted to be the greatest Lady M who ever lived. I mean, I got to first switch, so I'm pretty close. No makeup. And, yes, I've always wanted to do a horror film.
Have you?
A real horror film, you know, Frankenstein or Dracula. And now I'd like to do science fiction as well. I'd love to be a monster.
You'd like to be a monster? Mm, really?
Yes, I would. Mm? I love Star Trek.
You